Let's do some subtraction of integers. The good news is that we don't actually subtract, but I'm still going to write it as a subtraction problem. Okay, let's go with 8 minus 6. Now the good news is that 8 minus 6 is still equal to 2. But I want to tell you how to think it and how to read it or write it on the number line. Remember, this sign says the opposite of. Well, in this particular case, it means to add the opposite of. So if I have 8 minus 6, it really means add, and the opposite of that positive 6 is a negative 6. So I'm going to go over to an 8 on the number line, and I'm going to add to it 6 in the negative direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we still end up with a positive 2. So that hasn't changed since kindergarten. Let's try another one just like that. Let's say that we have 5, and I'd like to take away 4. Well, that subtract sign says, actually the definition of the subtraction sign is add the opposite. So I'm going to change this to, I'm going to keep the 5, I'm going to change this sign to an addition sign, and the opposite of this positive 4 is now a negative 4. So I'm going to go over to the number line, and I'm going to start at 5, and from there I'm going to add 4 in the negative direction. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the answer is still a positive 1. All right, let's try another. Let's go with, how about 8 minus a negative 3? Now, when I see a subtraction sign, from now on, even if it's an 8 minus 6, I want to get you in the habit of adding the opposite. So in this case, this says 8 subtract a negative 3. And that really means 8 plus, and what's the opposite or additive inverse of a negative 3? Positive 3. So I'm now going to go to an 8, and I'm going to add 3 in the positive direction. 1, 2, 3, and I'm at 11. Okay? I think we'll do, let's do 1 minus 4. When I see the subtract sign, what am I going to do? I'm going to change the sign to addition, and I'm going to make that 4 the additive inverse or the opposite. So this really says 1 plus a negative 4 on the number line. So I'm going to go to a positive 1, and I'm going to add 4 in the negative direction. 1, 2, 3, 4. And my answer is going to be a negative 3. And once you have it in this condition, you can look again and say, well, I know it's going to be negative because I have more negative than positive. And you can compare absolute value of 1 to an absolute value of 4. The difference is 3, but we know it's a negative 3 because we have more negative than we have positive. All right, let's do a negative 4 minus a negative 8. Okay, this says that I'm going to start at a negative 4, but I don't subtract, do I? Anytime you see the minus sign, the subtract sign, we're going to add, keep the first one, add, change the sign to an addition, and change the next number to its opposite. So I'm going to negative 4 plus, and the opposite of a negative 8 is a positive 8. I now have a negative 4 plus a positive 8. So let's go to a negative 4, and let's add 2 at 8 in the positive direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and I end up with a positive 4. Without the number line, another way to look at it is compare a 4 and an 8. The difference is 4 when you compare them in absolute value, and we know it's going to be a positive 4 because we have more positive than we have negative. Now you can do the same thing with fractions or with decimals. Let's try some easy fractions. Negative 5/8 minus 1/8. Now we're going to do the very same thing that we've been doing. You don't even have to look at the denominators right now. That says a negative 5 minus 1. Well, we don't subtract. So that's going to be a negative 5 plus what kind of 1? A negative 1. And a negative 5 and some more negative. Remember when the signs are the same, when you're adding more of the same? So that's going to be a negative 6 over 8. And if we wish to reduce that, it would be a negative 3/4. A lot of times you're going to see me put the sign with a top number, when in fact in literature often you're going to see it right in the middle. That just means one of the numbers, not both, is negative. I just have a tendency to put it with a top number. Let's try another fraction. Let's say 2/5 minus, I think 3/15. Now we're going to have to get a common denominator. That means what will 5 and 15 both go into? And that will be 15. Okay, so I'm going to begin by restating it with a common denominator of 15. 5 into 15 goes 3 times, and 3 times 2 is 6. Minus, and this is already 15s. Now, I know that 6 minus 3 is 3. But since I have a subtraction sign and that sign means add the opposite, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep the 6. I'm going to change the sign to addition, and I'm going to change the next number to its opposite. That now says 6 plus a negative 3. And if I need to, I could go on the number line to a 6 and add 3 in the negative direction. But I'm still going to end up with more positive than negative. And so 6 plus a negative 3 is a 3 over 15. And it is going to be positive because I had more positive fraction than negative. And I can reduce this if I like. What will go into both 3 and 15? 3. 3 into 3 is 1. 3 into 15 is 5. So I can reduce it further to 1/5. So don't be bothered if they give you fractions. You might have to get a common denominator. But once you have your common denominator, you can just hide the bottom and look at it and rename it as an addition problem. Okay, let's try a decimal this time. I'm going to say 4.2 minus 1.1. Well, we're building up to algebra here, so I'm going to do what I normally do with that sign. I'm going to change that subtraction sign to an add, an addition. I'm going to say 4.2 plus a negative 1.1. I know that I have more positive than negative just by looking, so I'm going to take the difference. On decimals, remember the decimal points line up, and I'm going to subtract, and I'm going to get a positive 3.1. Okay, let's try another. Let's say I have a negative 6.4, and I would like to subtract a negative 2.3. And I'll put parentheses for cleanliness. I don't subtract. I'm going to keep the first number. I'm going to change the subtract sign to addition. And I'm going to change the next number to its opposite or additive inverse, which is a positive. Now you can tell by looking that we have more negative than we have positive. So I'm going to take the difference of these two, and it's going to end up to be a negative answer. So I already know it's going to be a negative, so I'm going to put a negative. So I'll just put 6.4, take away 2.3. We've already decided there's more negative than positive, so the answer is going to be a negative 4.1. All right? Now, let's go back to the lemonade stand now that we know how to do subtraction. And let's see if we can work it a different way rather than just through addition. So let's say on Monday we made a profit of $7. On Tuesday we had a loss of $5. On Wednesday we had a loss of $6. On Thursday we had profits of $10. And it was so good that we worked on Friday, and Friday, I think we had a profit of $5, okay? Now, there are two different ways there are three ways that you can work this. The first way, we can make it all addition like we did in a previous video. The second way is we're gonna write it with addition and subtraction. So let's try that. I'm gonna write 7 minus 5 minus 6 plus 10 plus 5. Now before we begin, if you choose to do it this way, every time you come to a subtract sign, we don't subtract. So we've got to set it up. Keep the first number, change the sign to addition, and change the next number to its opposite. So this is going to be 7 plus a negative 5. That's going to be a negative 5 plus a negative 6. And these are already positive. Now from here, we're back to an addition statement. We can grab all the negative, if you like, which is a negative 5 and a negative 6 is a negative 11. And we can add to it a set positive 7, positive 10, and positive 5. So 7 and 10 is 17, and 17 and 5 is 22. Now, you know that we're going to have a profit here because we have more positive than we have negative. And the difference between the absolute value of 11 and the absolute value of 22 is 11, and it's going to be in a positive 11. So I made a profit of $11 on my lemonade stand. Now, if you don't want to do it in an addition or subtraction statement, you might want to do it in a table. I'm going to have my profit table and my loss table. And I'm going to have a profit on Monday of 7. I'm going to have a loss of a negative 5, a loss of 5 on Tuesday, loss of 6 on Wednesday, a profit on Thursday, and a profit on Friday. And now you can just add all the profit, add up all the loss, and then get the difference. So we have 17 and 5 is 22. We have a negative 5 and a negative 6 is a negative 11. When I add those two together, there's more positive than negative. And so the profit wins out and a profit of $11.